of sunshine. What did you do to that yesterday and today? I've been down there with some old friends from to see some of our friends from here as well. Now, what keeps you coming back to Toronto and giving your booking agents some of the dates? I really don't know. I think we've always had really good experiences here. I think that city seems somewhat similar since the Canadian city, so maybe there is something growing in the atmosphere and musical things, so I don't know. I think there was another last year or earlier this year that we actually did either because I was in a really bad start or just the vibe was fantastic and you didn't want to do it again. It's both a really good club, but also a very special combination of nice people, friends, being something to do. If I don't say to the next time, you know, sticking in mind, most of you remember them for the last. So it was to me that the new sound is even more interesting. Well, of course, it's a question of balance between educating and entertaining. So if you only offer people new sound, new stuff, it doesn't work as well if you have balance of something that they know and something that they like and the new stuff. So it's always both. Do you have to do with any new Canadian talent? And is there someone else that's really striking your mind at saying, well, that he or she is going to be the next big thing? I think you're refreshing that. I think that there is a lot of the best stuff is coming from these young, quite new producers. There are some of our all-time favorites, like BT, Royale, Press, Profile, and so on. They're doing quite well with some stuff. So it's mainly the new producers. To me, personally, I think David West are my favorite producer and performer. Of course, both have been around for a long time, but they made a big hit for them this year and last year. An amazing talent from the UK, a producer called Matt Zell. I think he's 17 or 16, and doing stuff that sounds like, I don't know, whatever, best producer in the world. That's quite special. How is the trance and the other electronic dance genres seen in Finland? Is it, you know, pretty common here on the radio? Is it supported by the government? In Finland, I would say that the success of the road helped a lot with the getting support support from not financial support, but overall expectation of support from government and cities and so on. After that road, you know, when I was listening to trance, and it got too big. And I think that when some of the high people have left the scene of the big spell, and the actual mid-flowers are still more. But I think the overall also involved with Phillips National Radio. Is it important to be on the radio as a DJ?
Yes, I see it quite important. At least in Finland, well, 10 years ago, radio was much more important than nowadays. Nowadays, music always can find their music from the web. But 10 years ago, it was very important in introducing new music and new styles to people. Of course, it's also globally. It's amazing how my radio show in Finland, people have track list posted from Russian sites or South American sites, or people say that there are rigs and that they can do a radio show that spread out around the world. So I would say even if it's a local show still, because worldwide help as well.
Do you like the way I think for the music, or does it sort of seem to find your way?
It's like I'm saying, like, you know, against two friends or relatives and so on. I think it's really important to keep up writing for the music, and also, if they're not happy, your voice hopes being more. Like, if I go to the other one, the record hoping is not as important as it used to be. But the same way, to go through the amazing amount of music, there isn't people and places like that. But just trust that the labels will send me the music on, someone will give me about it. So, because if you go through 1,000 tracks in Beatport, you want to find something that's not something that everybody's playing. Because I think there is so much music that I know that I would like or love, but just won't find.
Do you find that's a problem? The whole digital boom, places like Beatport and iTunes and so on, thousands of new labels, tracks each week. Do you sign up to them? Is it more of a pool, or is it just making you dig a little harder to find that gem?
I think it's definitely a good thing that we have all the shops. And it's great that now a lot of people who might not have got their music released 10 years ago have the chance now. But I think it's missing now more of a really good tool for finding the music. And I think that's something that technology would develop on to get better tools for finding the music that you like. Maybe Pandora or Last.fm are a bit that kind of systems, but I think Beatport, I hope in some way, would be more wise with what it's offering to me.
That sounds good. Well, we'll have a look at it and play with an hour or so, and we'll have a look at it.
Yeah, me too. And of course, I'll choose to play at that kind of thing, but yeah, should be good night.
Excellent.